I loved every minute of it, but this year was the sweetest.
It was a good year for the Houston Rockets and Houston City of Houston. Hang with us, baby, because we'll be back.
I look forward to seeing my mom and dad and sisters anytime I can when they come visit here or when I go back home. And, you know, it's a close-knit community where, you know, if I get back, everybody knows it, and I got a lot of friends there, and we all get together and talk a little bit about the season and whatever have you. And, you know, my mom expects me to come back. As soon as the season's over, when you coming home, you know, when you leaving.
We treat Ralph as Ralph, not as a basketball player. When he gets back to Virginia, he will be Ralph. And even though I'm not working now, if there needs to be something done in the house, Ralph will do it just like the girls.
Basketball is a fun sport, and I think I've achieved a lot of things in it, and I want to achieve a lot more. And I'm having fun doing it. And as long as I'm having fun, then I'll continue to play.
I started playing basketball when I was 17 years old. I used to play soccer when I was 2-3 years old. I've been playing soccer. Then all of my friends were telling me I was too tough to play soccer. Then it's bad for me to play basketball. And I didn't know anything about basketball until I saw a coach. He was a Nigerian national coach. He was just riding through our neighborhood. Then they saw me playing soccer. He opened his trunk and gave me a basketball and took me to the basketball gym. You know, showed me an example how to do a layup, and I couldn't do it. Then he was trying to show me how to dunk the ball, and I couldn't dunk, you know, for a couple of weeks. Sometimes I just couldn't believe what had happened between the last 6 years to me. I mean, it was unbelievable. Sometimes it just seems like a dream.
Entering the 1986-87 NBA season, the Houston Rockets, who had been seen as an up-and-coming young team before their appearance in the NBA Finals, were now viewed as title contenders and expectations became greater. Ralph Sampson began the season on the bench due to injury, but the team didn't let that get in the way, earning a victory over the Lakers, their Western Conference Finals opponents from the previous year, on opening night. Rodney McRae put in the performance of the night with 28 points on 12 of 15 shooting.
Of course, a lot of people probably said last year, was it for real, was it not, but we wanted to come out here and show that the team we were last year was no fluke at all, and we're better this year.
One thing I asked him when Ralph got hurt, I said, now you've got to come up with 20 points a night, and he's been anywhere from 15 to 20 point in average since that time. And he also has to do a lot of our ball handling, and that our guard position has been up and down.
Jim Peterson, now in his third year in the league, would also step up while Sampson was on the sideline.
My role is to play 20 minutes a game, come in and rebound, hit the open jump shot, be a hustler, a tough defender.
His stats may not show it because he had to play a different role, but the fact that he played the role of a starter and help us, you know, stay close enough to the pack that we got a chance of catching them with everybody back now, I think is a credit to him.
With confidence, you know, it breeds success, and I think when you start having success, you know, you just get more and more confidence, and it just starts snowballing. And, you know, unless you play, it's hard to, you know, get a lot of minutes, it's hard to get that confidence rolling. It's a big transition. It's a good thing, actually, because you know that with the injury of Ralph Sampson, that I'm going to be able to take my shots, and if I miss them, I'm probably not going to come out of the game.
Peterson, probably. You could throw it to him, and they just bounce off like a wall.
I always give Pete the credit for having the worst hands.
I'd say, in cohesion with the other people, probably would have said Jim Peterson.
You almost have to Western Union your pass to Jim Peterson, and it's like as you're coming down the floor, and you have to look at him and then move your lips. I'm getting ready to pass you the ball, Jim. Catch it, please.
The other 11 guys besides me, I think. This guy has terrible hands. It's incredible. I'm the only one that can catch the ball.
Substitution for Houston, checking into the game, number 50, Ralph Sampson for Jim Peterson.
The other half of the Twin Towers would make his season debut against the Cavaliers on November 16th.
Now they've got the isolation they want on Sampson, puts it up, it goes in, and he's fouled. So his first regular season shot could be a three-pointer.
In the lineup along with Olajuwon and Reid, he can go over the top a lot, just like that.
the Rockets would win the game in a dominating performance to put their record at 5 wins and 2 losses on the young season. The next night in Portland, Sampson would suffer another injury and headed back to the bench.
Sampson may be favoring that ankle just a little bit as he goes back to the defensive end.
I think it will show the fans the fact that we're really committed to our program, and that we're willing to put the money on the line and put the guaranteed contracts on the line, because these guys don't come along, every day.
You know, I've been there since I've been in the United States, so I'm used and proud. I love this city. This is where I wanted to be.
Hakeem would also join the injured list 1 week later in a loss at Madison Square Garden, the team's third in a row.
I thought that he had ruptured a medial collateral ligament because it was a classic type of injury and type of direction of blow or pressure that would do that type of injury.
Well, it happened so quick that, you know, you just hope that it's not as serious as it looks. And I mean, that looked like a very bad injury.
I was disappointed because it was very painful. The next thing I saw, I was in the hospital. I'm so glad it wasn't as serious as I thought.
This triggered a run of poor form that lasted through December. Rodney McRae would also leave the team shortly as he struggled through one of the most difficult situations imaginable after receiving news about his daughter, April.
She fell Thanksgiving Day and hit her head, so we took her to the emergency room.
They found out she had a brain tumor, which is in a part of the brain that's inoperable.
Being around the guys, they know the situation I'm in. They are very helpful. My family members and friends are very helpful. The fans have been great, sending stuffed animals, letters, and just doing everything that they can do, and they've made it, the situation, much easier to deal with.
The losing is the toughest, the grind of the losing. You're playing with such great athletes in every city. In other words, 23 cities, you've got such great athletes, and there's so much involved that you're expected to win. You're always on stage. You're always out front. And you're dealing with athletes that are really in the pressure cooker. They're catching airplanes at 5 a.m. They're trying to live a life that burn the candle at both ends a lot of the time. It's a real merry-go-round.
My Christmas wish is that on Christmas Day, there are families who would definitely have a Christmas meal. No one go hungry. And that every kid who does wake up, there is at least that one gift.
I'd like to wish my family a happy and merry Christmas and New Year's, and wish my teammates and their families the same.
Well, I wish everybody peace on earth and a lot of good health.
But my Christmas wish is get the Houston Rockets some more wins.
For the fans to just keep coming to the game, you know, we open the tunnels around.
A Boxing Day loss against the Lakers followed by defeat in Utah the next night left Houston with a 10-17 record heading into a game against the Clippers on December 30th that they would win. The team were healthy and finding form, and they won again in Denver.
And the Houston Rockets start 1987 off with a big win in the Mile High City.
They would continue to play well to start 1987 with wins over Seattle, Indiana, Dallas, and Phoenix at home.
Mitchell Wiggins and Lewis Lloyd of the Houston Rockets have tested positive for the use of cocaine. Accordingly, under the anti-drug agreement between the NBA and its Players Association,
Mitchell Wiggins and Lewis Lloyd are permanently disqualified from playing in our league.
In the back of our mind, we know there are two key players missing, but we can't think about them right now.
The two guys that were in the situation hopefully will get help and prepare themselves for their future life. For this basketball team, we just have to come together and be stronger.
We've spent 3 years now with this ball club, and one of the main themes has been anytime something negative happens to us, we're going to turn it into a plus. Steve is the first guy that really had the pressure put on him when we lost Wig and we lost Lou.
But he told me I would probably have to contribute more. You know, losing those two guys, I would have to come in and help the team more. You know, if it takes defense and offense, both, that's what I try to do.
Shut down everybody. Put down everybody. Can't make it all alone. I felt the dreams
alone. They began an Eastern Conference road trip, defeating the Bulls and then the Pistons to finally pull their record back to even at 500.
We keep track not only of the players in the NBA, but the players in the CBA as well, and to have some idea of the value of that player to us.
Last year, the Celtics soared past the Rockets to capture the championship. Now Houston gets their first shot at revenge. The rematch next Sunday on CBS Sports.
It came out of nowhere. All of a sudden, got a call from my attorney. This was on a Friday, and said there's a possibility of you being traded. This was in the morning. He called me back 2 hours later, told me I was traded to the Rockets, and to meet the Rockets in Boston Sunday. There I was in Boston Garden with a brand new team and a contending team.
Last June, the Boston Celtics won their 16th NBA title in triumphant fashion over a surprise opponent. The Houston Rockets had impressed everyone as the new power in the West, having crushed the Lakers before finally bowing to Boston. A new rivalry seemed to be born. This year, both Houston and Boston, to a lesser extent, are struggling. Injuries have limited the Celtics, Bill Walton in particular, the team in general. But things are worse in Houston. Injuries to both of the Rockets' twin towers, off-the-court rumors of internal friction, and the latest bombshell, two players dismissed from league play for drugs.
With the ladies?
I think everybody on the team has had their experiences with the ladies.
You got so many guys who say they're lovers, and you can't believe it once they're telling you this.
I'll leave that to the single guys. I'm married, so I don't want to touch it. Dear, I'm not touching that one.
Hakeem.
Bob Joseph.
Steve Harris.
I couldn't tell you.
Jim Peterson.
Robert Reid.
After the loss to the Celtics, Houston reeled off four straight victories and their record wouldn't fall below 500 again that season. Ralph Sampson would suffer a third injury and spend the latter part of the season on the road to recovery.
I'm going away, and it won't be long.
I had the ball on a trailer play at the top of the key. I kind of slipped on a wet spot on the floor or something. I thought it was fine after that. I ran back and down the court a little bit, and I went to turn, and my knee locked up on me.
Samson's hurt. Samson hurt either his left knee or his left ankle. Oh, he's in pain now. Look at that.
He's telling the doctor, please,
Watch the pressure.
I'm going and it won't be long.
Well, you do everything you can to prevent, but that doesn't seem to always be the answer. But it's all a matter of luck. I don't think it's what you do or whatever happens. You know, in Akeem's instance and Ralph's instance, it's just the type of injuries that occur that you can't prevent.
Center. He and Sampson comprise the twin towers of the defending Western Conference champs. 7 feet from the Houston Rockets, Hakeem Olajuwon.
Just do that train is out of that movie eye. Just do the train is out of that movie eye.
After 4 or 5 days, and after I got off the crutches, and after the pain went away, I kind of went on a program of maybe 6 hours a day. I started lifting weights with my upper body and did a lot of swimming, did some agility drills in the pool, and I think it helped out a lot.
Once you do start getting to the fact of playing playoff games, you've got to have a strong bench. You've got to have guys to come in and fulfill those minutes, that if your starters get in foul trouble or somebody, God forbid, gets hurt, you have people who have the confidence to step on the floor.
I think that you always gain from adversity. For instance, a Dave Feidel has played a lot more basketball already than he probably would have played as a rookie here in Houston had the Towers remained healthy.
I'm going wild, never get.
Mavericks coach Dick Motta was fined toward the end of the season for accusing Bill Fitch of throwing games in order to secure a more favorable playoff matchup.
If he's able to catch the ball and kick it in, Donaldson's got the play made. But if we come out and we're really alive and slow this guy down, now he's in there 3 seconds. And that's where we said you got to get your body on top, Dream. This play you got to anticipate so that when he's coming down, you got to get up on top so that he can't make that pass in.
The Dallas Mavericks and your Houston Rockets.
If you don't feel me singing, look what a fool I've been.
Houston finished the season with a 42-40 record and headed up the country to Portland to face the Trailblazers in the opening round of the postseason.
I'm going to someplace where I've never been.
The Blazers were led by Kiki Vandeweghe and Hakeem's former University of Houston teammate, Clyde the Glide Drexler. After taking Game 1, the Rockets returned to Houston for Game 3 with the series tied. They won both of their home games convincingly and continued up the Pacific Coast into the state of Washington for a second round matchup against the Seattle Supersonics.
Supersonics have pulled off another big victory on Houston's home court. And now Bernie Bickerstaff and the boys head back to the Great Northwest with a 2-0 lead.
Seattle Supersonics continued their dominance over the teams from Texas. First, the Sonics eliminated Dallas. Now they have jumped up on Houston 3-1 in the best of seven series as they head back to Houston. This game was a very physical, emotional ball game. This is a club, Seattle, which finished the regular season with a sub-500 record. Now the Sonics are playing like champions. Tom Chambers was the catalyst, taking the ball right at the Houston big men. The 6'10 veteran from Utah was in command. While Hakeem Olajuwon and Ralph Sampson got into foul trouble, Chambers scored a game-high 38 points. He pulled down 8 rebounds to lead this team, which has 2 rookies and 7 players which arrived this season.
I didn't know we'd all come together, 8 new bodies, and be able to perform this way. It's just been a fairy tale season for the Supersonics. We've come back up into the rakes in the NBA in one season when we all figured it would take a few.
Seattle is for real. I'm Tim Brandt for CBS Sports.
And there is no truth to the rumor that the Supersonics are changing their name to the Surprising Supersonics.
Despite dominant performances from the Dream, Houston couldn't come back and would be eliminated after losing in double overtime in Game 6.
And the Rockets, trailing by 2 and 52 seconds to go in second overtime. Ralph Sampson has scored 19, playing with 5 fouls. But look at those numbers for the high scorers.
Boy, have been some big numbers, but Ellis made a big play. Now, the last time the Rockets came up the court, Reid took the shot, and they didn't go to Olajuwon. Tough press situation now. They're going to let Sampson bring it up against Chambers.
And now Kevin Williams
in there to harass McRae.
And Bickerstaff said he's not afraid to put Williams on him.
and he's doing it in pressure situation. Here's Reed popping out with 9 seconds. Long rebound. Maxwell gets it. He used his big reach to hold off the Sonics. That's years of experience to get the offensive rebound.
He's a master at that.
22 seconds to go. Olajuwon trapped. Sampson is open. Rebound McDaniel. 15 seconds to go.
And they can run out the clock, Dick.
Ellis.
So I think my final thanks would be to God for just helping us all get through this season and realize that it really isn't maybe as important as we thought.
The birds in the trees, my heart sings a rhapsody of love for you. Girl, you won my heart the very first time I laid eyes on you. Someone else, but girl, I got to have you for myself. So I'm gonna keep on trying, just keep on trying till I win your love.
The Twin Towers wouldn't remain in Houston much longer. On December 12, 1987, Ralph Sampson was traded to the Golden State Warriors.
That's what you are, from the heavens above. You're a picture of love.
Injuries would continue to wear him down. He would play in less than 30 games in each of his final three seasons, playing in Sacramento and Washington, before retiring in 1992.
Ralph Sampson in street clothes on the bench for Sacramento. No one really knows when he's going to be able to play. He's had surgery on both knees. It's just a question mark.
Say if, would have, could have, no injuries barred, and maybe I'd have played a few more years and done a few more things, but that's part of the game. I had a great NBA experience, and I wouldn't trade it for the world.
The expansion committee originally recommended three cities, with Miami and Orlando battling for the final franchise, but the Board of Governors opted to include all four cities. The four teams will be playing by the 1989-90 season.
Keep on trying, got to keep on trying till I'm winning your love, no matter what it takes.
Daniel puts it up at the buzzer and go!
After being eliminated by the Dallas Mavericks in four games, the Rockets replaced Bill Fitch with former U of H Cougar, Don Chaney. Robert Reid would be traded to Charlotte in the summer of 1988 after spending 10 years in the city of Houston.
Give and show the enthusiasm. Let it be known that, hey, we can win, and don't quit. I know good enough well Robert Reid is not going to bounce the ball nowhere near as long as a Kareem Abdul-Jabbar, because they are going to be fine point guards and shooting guards and small forwards who are going to come in, and I'm going to look up one day and I'm going to shake their hand and say, hey, go at it, young buck, because I'm out of here.
He would also spend seasons in Portland and Philadelphia before retiring in 1991.
Let me say this. When I came in the league, 1977, there was only 19 NBA teams. My teammates were Moses, Cal Murphy, Rudy T. And I stood 6'9", but I played four positions. 1, 2, 3, and 4. I didn't want to come out the game. Shorts up to here, socks up to here, big afro. But we had some fun. We played hard for the city of Houston.
Rodney McRae and Jim Peterson would also be traded away that year, with the team acquiring Otis Thorpe to strengthen the front court.
Alley-oop. Patrick Ewing in the game, and Ewing gets the basket.
Now that was brute strength. Very, very strong move for Patrick.
So Patrick Ewing in the game for the East. Feed inside to Olajuwon, blocked by Ewing. And they're going to tie him up and jump him, and Patrick Ewing tied up Hakeem Olajuwon on a stuff attempt, and that's the defensive play thus far.
Belongs to someone else, but girl, I got to have you for myself.
For myself, keep on trying.
Oh, baby, not till I win your love. Girl, I'm gonna keep on trying. Oh, baby, not till I win your love. A falling star, that's what you are, from the heavens above. Girl, no treasure on earth can match your worth. You're a picture of love. I know to you, I'm just a lovesick guy, but you're wrong. I love you and I need you by my side.
By my side,
I'm gonna keep on trying. Oh, baby, not till I win your love. Girl, I'm gonna keep on trying.
Seattle once again was matched with the Houston Rockets in the first round of the 89 playoffs. Seattle had a 9-point lead with just 6 minutes left in the game. But the Rockets fought back, and a 3-pointer by Sleepy Floyd tied the game with 1 second to go.
Now McMillan will inbound. Who's it going to come to? Here's a lob pass and under to McKee. Back of the layup! It is good!
Oh!
Derek McKee with a layup on the inbound pass. He threw it off to the left-hand side. And
the Rockets acquired the rights to guard Vernon Maxwell in February 1990.
Keep on trying. Oh, baby, not till I win your love. Girl, I'm gonna keep on trying. Oh, baby, not till I win your love. I can't help but envy the gal that's got you by his side. Lord, he's got everything. There's no end to his happiness. Girl, I'll be in his place. I'd gladly give anything. Oh, yes, I would. I know your love belongs to him. But I could never be satisfied just being a friend.
Being a friend.